A man named Michael lived in a village. He had a big dairy shop. He used to provide milk, curd, and other dairy products in his shop.
Hey,
what is this? Where did so many flies come today? Oh shit. Let me throw this before anyone sees.
Michael was a miser. Uncle Michael, please give me 2 kg butter.
Sure, son, I will give you right away.
Hey, what is this? Uncle Michael, there is a fly in it.
What? A fly? Show me.
The boy shows Michael the box of butter.
Wait, son. I will give you another box of butter.
Michael takes out the fly from the box and hands over the same box to the boy.
Take this, son. Is it okay now?
Yes, Uncle Michael. Thank you. I will leave now. At that time, there arrived 2 sepoys from the palace.
Listen, Michael. 40 kg butter should be delivered by noon in the palace.
Yeah, sure. But such a high quantity of butter, is there a party in palace today?
Yes. Today the king has thrown a party for the ministers.
Okay. Don't worry. You will get the butter on time.
Sepoys leave. And Michael starts preparing butter.
Listen, Simon. We have to deliver 40 kg of butter to the palace by afternoon. Let's start working quickly. But master, we don't have enough milk to prepare 40 kg of butter. Do one thing, add half quantity water to the milk we have. That will do the work. But master, that will not be right. If the king finds this out, then he will punish us. You do your work quietly or get lost. Oh, okay, master.
Simon adds water to the milk, but even then, the quantity is not enough. Simon goes to his master to inform him.
Master, I added water to the milk, but even then, preparing 40 kg of butter is not possible. What shall we do now? Okay. You go out there and look after the shop. I will take care of this. Okay, master. I should add vegetable oil to this.
Michael takes the case of vegetable oil and adds the butter, and that fills the case of butter fully.
Wow, my work is done. Now I have to deliver this to the palace quickly.
Michael takes the case of butter to the palace and returns home after delivering that. All the ministers arrive at the party. The party was wonderful. The king welcomes the ministers wholeheartedly. All the ministers eat a lot of food. After the dinner, ministers meet the king and go back to their homes. The king offers each minister a box of sweets as return gift.
Wow, the aroma of the sweets is so good. I will also taste the sweets.
The king tasted the sweet happily. The ministers also enjoyed the sweets just like the king. After eating the sweets, the king falls sick.
Your Highness, the ministers have also fallen sick like you. What? How's this possible? Seems like something was wrong with the sweets. Go and call the chef.
Yes, Your Highness.
You fool! What kind of sweet did you make? Everyone has fallen sick after eating your sweets.
Your Highness, I prepared it very carefully. I have no idea what happened. Your Highness, I think all this happened because of Michael's butter.
Are you sure that all have fallen sick because of that butter?
Yes, Your Highness, because I could smell vegetable oil in that butter.
This means Michael cheats everyone with adulteration. General, send 2 sepoys to Michael's house to keep an eye on him. Yes, Your Highness.
Sepoys arrive at Michael's house and sneak up. The Michael was adding vegetable oil to the butter.
Oh, what's this? Michael is putting everyone in trouble by adulteration. Yes, we should catch him red-handed and take him to the king.
Yes, come quickly.
sepoys enter Michael's house and catch him red-handed.
You adulterate butter? Now you will have to answer the king.
No, please forgive me.
Come, now you will explain things to the king.
Sepoys bring Michael to the palace.
Your Highness, we caught Michael red-handed, adulterating butter.
Does this mean that you fool everyone?
Please forgive me, Your Highness. I made a mistake. I will never do this.
General, take him and throw in jail.
No, Your Highness, please forgive me. I will never do this.
The king does not listen to Michael, and the general throws him in jail.